Greetings, welcome back to Pyre. Let's continue our journey toward your freedom. At dawn, Wolfred is already up. He reveals to you a pathway through the woods into the cold lands of the north, beyond which lies your next destination. Skolian Shore. You get clear of the woods at last, and arrive in lands grown cold in the shadow of Mount Arodia. You'll have to make it all the way to the top. In a moment of respite, Wolfred calls everyone together to discuss matters pertaining to the rites and the plan to which he alluded. You banded together with a common faith that freedom from the downside is not impossible. Am I correct? But let me ask you something. What does freedom even mean to you? He looks in your direction as he asks, defying you to answer. You cannot sense his own thoughts on the subject, and only know the truth of how you feel. Freedom means living life without concern for others' judgment or approval. You told Wolfred that freedom means living without fear and not being subject to persecution or retaliation for one's thoughts and choices. He considers your remarks for a short while. But also, my girl, I happen to agree. Fear takes hold in freedom's wake. But fear is a natural impulse, is it not? A common feeling we all share from time to time, a deeply rooted impulse there to aid our judgment and spur us on to act of courage. If not for fear, I doubt we could accomplish very much in life. And just now we stand upon the brink of accomplishing something vital. He then turns his attention to the whole group. Now, let me tell you all what freedom means to me. Freedom means to live life without fear, just as your leader stated. To be able to indulge one's curiosities and passions, at least the ones that cause no harm to others, without the constant threat of judgment and reprisal. Freedom means not being made a criminal of what you know, or whom you love, or what you choose to think or not think. He looks out toward the distant mountains. Within the next few days, your time in exile could come to an end. You could see the Commonwealth once more, and you will be exalted there, given the highest honor, the opposite of how you got here. But you would not be truly free, I think. At the last, you would become complicit to an ancient system that would disdain to cast down all the such as you. It is a system whose well-intentioned founding principles have long been lost, and the eight scribes, if they are out there still, have made quite clear they shall not intervene with firsthand. That is where you come in. He turns to you and everyone again, looking to each other. Long have I wished to gather such a group, that together you might see that seeking freedom only for yourself is too modest of a goal. You share a higher calling now. The plan then is this. We free each other from the downside through the rites. Then we meet up on the other side. We organize. Each new moon at dusk, we join together at the Spiral Sanctuary. We need as many of us there as possible. My agents on the other side shall explain the rest. We're plotting a revolt. Just so, I am asking a lot. You do not have options. Deceit, however, is not one of them. The reader and myself, you know by now that we can see through it. But you need not be a part of this, nor is it in my interest to coerce you. You may go your own way if you wish. Live out your remaining days here, like so many others. So, if anyone among you prefers that, if you cannot see yourself continuing to strive together in the Commonwealth, as you are doing here, then speak now. Wolfert pauses for a time, examining each member of the group. No one stirs. Very good. Some of you consider yourselves friends, some others not. But all of you are bound together through the rites and are integral to our plan. Remember that. You seek true freedom, you will not find it waiting for you in the Commonwealth. But together, you can bring it about, both for yourselves and others. That is my promise. Then he lets out a long breath. That's it. I ask all of you to think of the on this, and let's reconvene along our way to the summit. Wolfred turns toward the mountains, leaving you to consider what he said and plot the way against Snowball's path to the Moose Pass. Beyond lies Mount Alodial. I suggest we make camp here at the base of the mountain, for we shall need our spirits and our strength to make the ascent. There you are, my girl. There was something which I wanted to discuss with you in private. Wolfert stares at you rather intently, as if reaching out to you, and then... Chantage, Amitas. You do know what it means to be a leader? Those such as we are not limited to reading pages from a book. Though your ability in this I sense is nascent, still, my flashes uncontrollable. I see as well now that they haven't told you yet, your friends. And that explains a lot. They haven't told you it is such as you cannot go free. I had wondered why you would insist on pressing onward with this group in light of this. The answer then was plain. You simply did not know or fully realize. They did not deceive you, by the way. There is no reason they would know themselves other than Tariq, who shall not influence your thinking in such matters. Rather, I had expected, when at first we met, that you already knew the truth of this form, having read the passage in the Book of Rites, which states in plain, only those who shall conduct the rites firsthand shall walk the path toward enlightenment and become eligible to regain their freedom. Perhaps you have not gotten to that part just yet. Wolfert breaks free from you and looks at you again, then he speaks to you as normally. It is plain that you are not in adequate condition to conduct the rites, and this group values you as a leader. I wish only to ensure you understand what you are getting into here. Despite whether hopes and dreams and promises might have been shared, I do not think the rites can help you to return, if that is what you had in mind. So, once again, I invite you to depart, and I will see to it that you are compensated. Do not misunderstand. If it is your wish to remain, then you are welcome. But this journey we are on, it has no guarantees. Not for you, nor any one of us. Do you understand? You understand the words of warning, yet just the same, you chose to carry on. There is more that you wish to achieve on this journey than freedom for yourself. I admire that, my girl. Then, very well. Know that we have much at stake here, in this anyway. Much more than just a shot at going back into that Commonwealth which cast us down here to begin with. It sounds like you intend to stick around. Then we'll have lots more time to chat as we ascend the sacred mountain in the coming days. Until then, he strides out of the wagon then, leaving you with your thoughts. I sense my lovely reader has returned then. How may I assist you? Of course, reader, you need but think on who shall be the subject of my trial and we shall go from here. ask Sandra to administer one of her special tries for Tizo. I think I remember something of that imp. He certainly stood out from all his ilk, although that really is not saying much. Well, let us bring him forth. Tizo soon appears in heat of the summons. Tizo seems to be prepared for whatever lies ahead. The apparition Sandra appears and unfastens her mask. Listen well, imp. You answer to me here. Tizo indicates his understanding and is prepared to begin Sandra's trial. You know the formalities, of course. Show me then what you have learned thus far about the rites. Here, in this trial, it shall be just you, my beyonders, and lovely leader. Let us see how you fare. Tizo is excited to have completed Sandra's challenge and awaits her approval. A worthwhile effort, imp. Your performance was sufficient and you passed my test. Your predecessor may well have approved. Thus, congratulations are in order to you and to your lovely leader. Now, farewell. Tizo is happy to be back and wonders what it is that Sandra granted you. You take a close look at the new artifact in your possession. You received Hope's Wing for completing Tizo's trial. Okay, let's discuss the plan. Earlier, Wilfred called for a group meeting, presumably to reveal his plan in more detail. Instead, he reveals some bad news. Wait, what are you saying? What I'm saying, my boy, is that while you can indeed get yourself out of here, it can be all of you at once. You can earn a way back one by one, not all at all. But I thought that we go free together. We may go free together yet, but it's going to take time and this is only the first phase. You, Hedwin, and the others exchange glances. Let me make this plain for you still. Here's how the coming days are going to unfold. First, we're going to ascend Mount Alodiel there to the north. You may not think this wagon's fit for it, though rest assured, it's made the journey many times. Next, we'll pass through Scribe's Gate. Only the wolfie passed through there, as your reader could attest, if she did not merely skim that chapter of the book. Afterwards, we'll reach the Fall of Solium and meet our adversaries in the rites. They are to be the Tempest, led by the demon Ignarius. You'll know him when you see him. Both you and they shall choose someone from your respective ranks. Then, once one of the Trinity rites prevail, somebody will be whisked home to the Commonwealth. Whisked home to the Commonwealth? Precisely. Once returned, somebody is taken in and clothed and fully pardoned. The Commonwealth knows about this all? The same Commonwealth they say a sentence into exile is forever and freedom from the Downsend is impossible? Many of these details the scribes themselves wish to be kept secret. Former exiles and the leaders of the Commonwealth alike have good incentive to protect those secrets well. So then, what's it? We climb the mountain, someone goes back and everyone else stays? For most of those participating in the rites, yes, that's it. But I like your connotation, and indeed for us that isn't it at all. If one of us returns, it shall be just a step along our path. However, let's let that sit for now. That is strength. We'll talk again on our way up. Wilfred leaves the rest of you to consider what he said. You have time now for your vocations. At dawn, you shall begin your ascent out of Mount Alodio. This knight shall be your eager protege. You and Sir Gilliman go over his understanding of his aura and its connection to his presence, both physical and spiritual. The discussion proves informative. So, great wisdom clouds over this knight's entire consciousness. This knight's aura, you have surely seen it, no? It cascades like a flowing waterfall. Let's head to the Mount Alodio. Here before you lies Mount Alodio, stretching far beyond your line of sight. Somewhere upon this mountain lies the only place from which you can escape the downside. Your companions gather around again before Wulfred, who stands tall as ever, whether from the cold air or the subject now at hand, you sense attention in the air. Now then, you all have many questions, no? I've done a lot of talking, so go on, ask away. But there is only silence. One question stands out in your mind, which you refrain from asking yet. If only one of you is free to go at first, who shall it be? Go on now, don't be shy. Who first? Questions. Why ask? Why you, indeed, madam? That I can explain. You've seen the soldiers stand against as adversaries in the right. What is it that they want, do you suppose? They want their freedom back, of course. They'll settle for it on the Commonwealth's own terms. They'll gain their freedom and some cash in responsibilities. Perhaps then they'll have a hand in sending still more exiles here to join us. Think of it. The Commonwealth rose from the ashes of the fallen empire thanks to the efforts of the first exiles who escaped this place via the rites. It is the Commonwealth's first and proudest tradition to honor those who live to redeem their transgressions. They have a certain wisdom, do they not? But as for you, I have been looking for a certain set of dispositions for a good length of time. All I needed was for somebody appropriate to show up and to listen. So I planted many little eyes and ears throughout this land, whispering hints of this, absurd as it may sound. Took someone with a certain faith and creativity to go for it. That someone proved to be Hedwin over there. He was tasked with seeking two trustworthy allies, an old bird wagon and a reader. He was invited to bring others for the ride, all different sorts, gather enough help and his friends could be free. Long story, but you know much of the rest. So then, why you? Because I have reasons to believe you're not the sort to play right back into Commonwealth's old hand. The rites, as you have seen, are quite exclusive. You are impostors in the city party. You could be the only ones to break it up. Now then, more questions. Your head is beginning to spin. You can excuse yourself or keep listening. Wilfred's explanations are a lot to take in. Do you feel compelled to absorb as much of what he is willing to tell you at this point? He prompts for further questions when Jodalia raises her voice again. Hold, you mistook my meaning. I understand your plan. Still, I wish to know why us. Why are we, among all others, chosen for this liberation rite? I see. Well, but that is simple, really, madam. You are chosen, you are qualified, I should say, because, as the expression goes, this is what describes ordained. Though, in this case, the expression is quite literally true. When the Eight created the rites, each one of them unwritten certain older exiles to participate on their behalf. Exiles who showed some promise of redemption. The triumvirates they formed have stood the test of time, replenishing their numbers as the individuals moved on or passed on. You've met them as they are today, the accusers, the withdrawn, and so on. The Eight Scribes are also formed as special groups, group against which all the others would be judged. That group they called the Nightwings. You bear their books, wear their masks and raiments. You need but to show up to the rites. You see, the elders erstwhile jockeying for position for a chance to take you on.
Yeah. What if you don't show up?
Then you would deny yourself a chance at freedom and deny it also to your adversaries. Victory means nothing in a common life. Then, participation is all that matters? Not so, madam. Only the enlightened may regain their freedom. While failure can be an excellent teacher, the scribes do favor the victor. So you see, those who do not conduct the rites or do not prevail in them sufficiently, they may find themselves barred from the liberation rites, but these are technicalities. The Nightwings disbanded years ago. Since then, no one has gone free. It's still the other triumvirates press on, with fleeting hope that one day you'll be back. It's been a heavy price to pay in all this. Now, if you excuse me, we'll talk again some other time. Some murmur to themselves about all this as Wilfred takes his leave. Others reconnoitre pathways leading up the mountain and present you with some options. You join Pamitha on her brief expedition to find anything of value dropped by those who tried to scale the mountain but did not succeed. Wait, I shall be joining you. What now? I get two chaperones? But sure, I'm game. You know your winkless are into. Be silent, Robert, and fetch those trinkets and be done. Why so full of bitterness? You really ought to make the most of this last precious moment that we share. And you ought not to mince your words. Oh, please, we all know you're going to be the first one out of here. So why not quit your constant frowning for a change? I, the first one out of here? Of course, it's plain the others pity you. You've been here longer than the rest of us, by far. Besides, maybe that Wilfred, though he seems plenty happy here, making his speeches. How dare you? How dare you to presume? Nothing is decided as of yet. No doubt, though if by some coincidence you do end up sacred for the honor, I just want you to know something. I truly from the bottom of my heart do hope we shall prevail on your behalf, because that way you shall be free. Of me at least. And I, in turn, shan't have to suffer any longer your hideous attitude toward me and everything. At that, you intervene, Jodalia's eyes burning with fury, but then she calms herself. I shall see you at the wagon, Wither. Pamitha scoffs as Jodalia storms off. I swear that one. Well, moving on, there's something sparkling down there. Be right back. She swoops out of sight, leaving you alone there on the mountain. Amifa soon returns with something that lay long forgotten in the rocks below. We found a fiery spirit. You sense its power.
At long last!
The room surges toward the water of the cistern. You decided to join him for a brief excursion there after another hard day's ride. You find him in a shallow pool, appearing very much contented.
This night, he thought he might never hear you again for short of school chaos against his scales.
He sighs, flashing you about from time to time. Then he turns his attention over to you.
You, Master Reader, you are most kind. To take with you this wayward knight, he swears to prove himself to you and to the rest. He knows that soon now someone may go free. He knows the choice of whom may wait upon you ever indeed. For it is you who ought to make the choice, is that not so? This knight, he heard it from the others, so it must be true. Now listen, please, upon what little honor this knight has. This knight's penance isn't yet complete. There's much atoning to be done. So, when rises the occasion to decide who ought to go free, this knight wants you to know something. Please, do not choose him. Not even if you wish, and not even if you can, he begs of you. Allow this knight that simple dignity.
With that, Sir Gilman sinks into the waters. He still waves to you to leave him be for now. Sir Gilman does not believe that he deserves his freedom yet. You and your companions gather at Scribe's Gate, where the single narrow trail to the summit narrows even more and falls under an archway carved of stone. Come along now, everyone, and be prepared to speak your mind when you are called. Frankly, most of you still lack enlightenment, but we may pass together, much how we act as with a single heart and mind doing the rites. Well then, lead onward, Tarik. Please, follow me. Removing his hat, the lone minstrel approaches the gate. You and all the others follow. When the last of your companions nears the arch, you notice someone standing high above, who then appears before you. She eyes the lone minstrel first. Is that you, Tarik? It is. Greetings, Celeste. And how was your rest? Too long, Celeste. It seems your work has piled up in the meantime. You bring this many to the gate? Aye. Then let us make this quick. She gestures toward the rest of you. Now, each of you in turn state who you are and what you seek whilst crossing Scribe's Gate. Do as she says, please, without questioning. Your fellow exiles exchange glances but quickly comply. I'll start. They call me Hedwin the Deserter. I've come here seeking freedom for myself and my companions. In my case, so I can return to be with one whom I love. The woman bids him forward. The lone minstrel prompts Rookie to speak up next.
I am regarded by the name of Rookie Quinte. I just want to get out of here, I guess with my chums, preferably go see Mama back home.
I am Captain Trudario. I do not truly know as yet what I am seeking here.
My name's Fe, and I'm here, I think, because the scribes have called to me. It must be them, because if not, then who?
Tizo seeks to live up to the Nightwing's legacy and maybe see the Commonwealth someday.
Sir William of the Sea Dominion, at your service. This knight is on a quest to find his power. He lost it at a certain point.
Funny fatin, and I'm only here because my sister's here. Then, as Wolfert steps forward, the one called Celeste raises her voice.
You,
I recognize you from the night wings of the past. You are not clad in the remnants any longer. I don't know why. I had my chance already. The Nightwings that now stand before you, I traveled with them as a pilgrim now. I see. Then state why are you here, as have the others. My name is Wilfred Sandalwood. I seek liberty for each of us, so that one day we all might stand shoulder to shoulder on the other side and bring our freedom to the people there. She waves him down. Then she turns to you, for there is no one left to go. State who you are, who traverses Scribe's Gate. I don't know who I am. You cannot, for the life of you, recall a time before arriving the downside. Details of the Commonwealth are scarred within your mind. Perhaps you wanted to forget the place. The one called Celeste continues to examine you, expecting you to add to your response. I want true freedom. You wish to gain freedom, not simply to return to the Commonwealth, but to be able to live there in peace. If Wilfred's plan shall bring about the peace, then you shall do your part to achieve it. The woman regards for a time. She then nods once and waves all of you by. The eight scribes speak the Nightwings welcome here. Go forth with glory. And Tarik? I, Celeste? Be on your way as well. The lone minstrel bows his head and puts his head back. He does not look back at her. From the top of Mount Alodiel, you can see the distant downside before you. You think on the many thousand lakes you crossed to reach this point as the sky grows dim. The mercy shown. The imp, Hope, and I, we helped to save the Emperor. And when the danger did subside, my Emperor saw the Amur. He said something to me which shook me to the essence of my being. He said, "You gave your freedom, Master Goliathian, so that I may yet have mine. You too now are an exile of the downside. In all the days which I have left, I never could repay the mercy you have shown me. So if I cannot do so in this life, then I shall do it in the next." We crossed the land together, and together with the imp, regained the company of those who saw in him what I did. Dario appears to be prepared for whatever is to come this night. Though it is not yet dark, she is already in her raiments. Edwin soon joins her, also looking ready. Any signs of Ricky? None as yet. Complain about our chastity at the collar of his mask. Our freedom might be hanging on that collar then. I am certain that it is. They shall unlock together. A few of you exchange glances, but nothing is said or needs to be said. Soon, if Wolfred is to be believed, one of your companions may regain his or her freedom.
Hey! What did I miss? Am I late? Is it starting? Is it starting yet?
Easy, rookie, we got a little time. It isn't starting yet. How far you struggles with your mask, Winter?
Feeling a lot better, thanks. Just have to smash a stupidity against the wall for a little bit. Put some of the old nerves to bed. There, good for measure. Though, this isn't really happening, huh? One of us might be getting out of here like soon.
Might don't, in fact, if all goes well.
If all goes well, that's one way to look at it, I guess.
What are you getting at, Winter?
Well, it's just we might be breaking up the band here, people. If one of us gets out, that's been bugging me a while now. I thought we all were getting out of here at once.
He shoots a look at you.
Some of us, we might not be getting out of here at all.
Edwin slams his fist against the wall. No, not if I can help it. We made a promise to each other, each of us, the four of us. We're all getting out of here. I care about the others too, I do. But we've been here from the start. I want you to know, my promise is to you. and I believe you'll do the same for me. So it's like this. If any one of us gets out, great, but it's just a start. We're going to do whatever it takes there on the other side to make it so the rest of us can get back too.
What do you think they're gonna build a bridge down here, if ask us, something?
I don't know what it's going to take. Just know we have to try. Rodarion turns to you. Either we shall find a way. She nods to reassure you and to reassure herself. Rookie nods his head in turn, and Hedwin's gaze never moves faltered. Well, my friends, I think it's just about time. Let's go. One by one, they turn towards the door. The fall of Solium awaits, a vital step in your quest for freedom. But you feel in your heart that it shall only be the first. Your three companions each gain hope with the liberation rite. River frost. So cold it can burn the skin, but keeps the waking cool and food fresher, longer. What brings you to me this time, my dear reader? Let me ask you something, lovely reader. Have you any idea for how long I have been imprisoned here? A thousand years? It appears that Sara could have been in her current state of exile since well before the dawn of the current age. At first she shows no indication that she even heard you. Close. Close enough, I shall be getting there. I have been imprisoned thus for 837 years. According to my count, at least, it is possible I have lost track, although given my state I can assure you that I have had ample time to verify my arithmetic. She goes silent for a time. Let me give you some advice. If you decide to kill the Emperor, make sure you achieve what you set out to do. I expected my own death regardless of the outcome of my task. I was not expecting this. Certainly not to be telling you about it 837 years later, or however long that it has been. Although, enough of that for now, let us get back to business. Come visit me again sometime when you need further practice. Hey guys, so just you all the way here now. I know how come you're here. How come you made it all the way up here? I know, right? You are here because I got the lowest prices and all the downside, am I right? And some of the new stuff I got in stock, you're gonna get a lot of value here. An awful lot.
You guys take care, okay? And thanks for doing business!
Let's commence the liberation rite.
Before the centers.
Is everyone prepared, Hedwin? Yes, though several of us have another question that's been troubling us. You need but ask. You said that one of us is going to return to the Commonwealth if we defeat the Templars in the rites this night. What happens if we fail? Edwin, my boy, don't you see? The path to freedom and the path to enlightenment are one and the same. Do you intend to stray from the path? No. Then you have nothing to fear. But let me be much more upfront with you. Should you be defeated by the Templars this night, then one of them shall end up going free instead of one of you. It is as simple as that. What then is to be done? The very same as if we achieve victory. We await our next such opportunity and make the most of it. Tonight, our plan is set in motion. We are united in our cause. We shall look as ever toward the stars for guidance and seize upon our future chances, just as they arise. So look up, my boy, and set aside your doubts. It is time to take great strides along the path.
Since last the Nightwings gained the summit of the Sacred Mountain and stood upon the fall of Solium. You are to be commended for your guidance, reader. But only if you can prevail in this liberation rite. Here you stand to gain much more than some enlightenment. Your adversaries are none other than the Tempers. I trust they need no introduction. Soon, one among you shall regain their freedom.
The pyres burn and each of the triumvirates present and prepared. I concur, the pyres burn and each of the triumvirates is present and prepared. Then, anointed one of the Tempers, come forth and declare yourself and pay any respect you have unto your adversaries, the Nightwings. A massive demon swarm is in the view. He reaches for his mask. You know who I am already. But look at what we got here. The damn Nightwings decided to show up. Almost figured we were never gonna see the day again. He takes notice of someone in the ranks. Hey, you! He indicates Rodario. She scoffs back at him. Lose the mask and see one of our only agents not in these damn ropes. Rodario's hesitation is almost imperceptible before she moves to remove her mask, just as her adversary asks. Satisfied? Whoa, you must be new. Rodario puts her mask back on. Enough talk. I like your curly horns. Tell you what, once we put out the lights, you come along with these guys. You're gonna have a spot open. Only shame, yeah, it's ain't gonna be allowed to show you a good time. I should rather cut out my tongue. Oh, you don't mean that, okay? We ought to stick together. No, come on! Ignarius throws his mask back on as his eyes snarls at the rest of you. Have the Nightwing switched to a decision of who? On whose behalf they shall conduct the strike? The long minstrel gets your attention in his subtle way. Reader, this is it. The first companion whom you choose shall be anointed to go free this very night if you prevail. The other two in the triumvirate shall lend their aid. As you may know, only the most enlightened in the rite are eligible to go free. Not all among you may be ready yet. Now, Nightwings, I would have your decision.
Most deserves their freedom.
Oh,
Dariel.
Me? Why? Then the gate guardian looks upon you and your adversaries. Very well. Then, under the watch of the eight scribes, here are the stakes of this eve's liberation rite. Should the Nightwings prevail, the one called Dariel shall be liberated. Should the Tempers prevail, the exiled Ignarius shall go free instead. She then turns to me. Now, who among the Nightwings shall complete your triumvirate to strive alongside Rodario and see to her return in glory?
Who shall lend her support? Tizo!
Tizo is more than willing to throw all his support behind Rodario this night.
Sir Gilden.
By this night's honor, he shall do his very best.
Ah,
Very well. The eight scribes accept your choices, leader of the Nightwings. Then indicates to the lone mistral. Now, are you yourself prepared, Taric? Aye, Celeste. Then let us all begin.
Nightwing, been waiting an awful long time to get out of this hole. Try and stop me.
Is good for nothing, Nightwings. Skip out on us for years and years and show up all of a sudden you're like gonna slap somebody out for once. But now we're gonna work forward for it, I guess. Damn, I used to be the best. At this glass. But now the pressure's getting to me. I can't believe it's going to be me. Ah, Moira. I doubt you ever recognize me anywhere. Come on, Nightwings, let's see what you is up.
The demon whom you face was once a man. Long since tainted by the downside. Or rather by his crimes. I suspect his penance is not yet complete. Beauteous! Once more like that, and we are finished here. at last. The Nightwings proved their worth. As for their adversaries, they did not. Thus ends the liberation rite. And thus the scribes have chosen. The exile appointed by the Nightwings shall be free, absolved of all misdeeds, returned to glory in the Commonwealth. Her adversary and all others shall remain to carry out their rightful sentences.
What a jump. We should have this. You should have had this. But Rusty, you've been waiting so damn long. Nightwings? Listen around, I guess. And next time, you ain't gonna be so lucky. After all this time, I turned my eyes toward the rest of you. I never thought this day would come. I have all of you to thank for this, for doing this for me. The life that I recall back in the Commonwealth was at times difficult, and I am much older now. I know not what I shall find on my return. However, I know this. If that place still is like the Commonwealth I left so long ago, then I shall strive to make it better. For as long as I retain my strength and breath, you see her smile faintly as she disappears to the shimmer pool, though you still can hear her voice, though faintly now. Farewell then, reader, all of you, for now. Jodariel earned back her freedom. May she return in glory.
Captain Jodariel. The eight scribes are ever merciful. By their grace, the cycle of the rites may soon commence again.
So grateful is this knight for such a glorious occasion that he is giving strong consideration to performing here and now the forbidden dance of Sea Dominion.
Until the rites begin anew.
After your victory over the Templars in the Liberation Rite, you return to your wagon to decide how to proceed from here. I don't know what I'm going to do without you here. Well, look on the bright side, it's only a small defeat. We'll see Jodariel again if we persevere. Our journeys now begin in earnest. We'll just need to make a few last preparations while we're here. What about the stars? Can we afford the time? Above doubt. Reader, go see for yourself. The night sky over Mount Olodil is much darker than you would have expected. Your thoughts are with Jodariel as you look toward the heavens, to gaze into the darkness of the night. Aqueth, the olden star of the Songfisher, those born under it are well cultured and influential. You search and search the sky, but in vain, no stars are shining now. The stars revealed nothing, did they not? You confirm his suspicion. It's as the book foretells, this is the chance we need to make ready for what lies ahead. There is a heaven south of here. We'll travel toward dawn. And when the stars decide to shine for us again, we'll be ready. Mark my words. You find Hedwig on his own after Jodariel's liberation. You sense straight away what is on his mind. The two of them were close, though, for much of his life. looks up at you, but his familiar smile is nowhere to be found. I'm sorry, my friend. I should be in a much, much better mood right now. It's just... I can't believe she's gone. Then he shakes his head. Listen to me. I'm talking like she... He falls silent again. You can tell he needs some time to himself right now. And turns to him. Wait, hold on. Don't leave me here just yet. First of all, my friend, thank you. I don't like to think of it in quite these terms, but out of all of us, I really hope she'd manage to get out of here. She's been here the longest. Not to mention, I'd probably be dead 10 times over by now, if not for her. What's more, maybe others there other than Wolfred himself, I have a feeling she's really going to make an impact on this plan of ours back on the other side. Just the same, though, I'm going to miss her. You and Hedwig share some memories of Rodario for a time, though it grows clear to you that he needs some time alone. Thanks again, my friend. I hope that one day all of us can meet again. Jody, she'd be happy on that day, I bet. It is very late now. We'll part ways after bidding each other a good evening. This is where it's gonna end for them. Thank you.
Bye bye.